I went for a year and 3 months, which at the end of the day, I think was like just sort of sexual anorexia. You know, I don't know that there's anything healthy about that approach in hindsight.
Why did you think you had sex addiction?
When I got to my late 30s and I was sort of knocking on the door of 40 and I was on this comedy tour and, you know, like hooking up with random chicks all the time, like it really occurred to me that is not the path to like happiness. And, you know, I thought I want to be happy. I want to have a good life. And I subscribe to the belief that that means I need to learn to have a healthy relationship so that I can have a, you know, a life partner. And I resolved to stop hooking up with random chicks on the road. And when I made that promise to myself, I was unable to keep it. And so therein is sort of the definition of addiction. I didn't want to do it, and I couldn't stop myself from doing it. So I got a therapist, and you know, I took it super, super seriously, like just the same way I did with drugs and alcohol.
How much did it help?
It helped a ton. You know, I mean, and like here, I'm a guy who doesn't know moderation. So when I got in that, when I was in that intensive program, which was in October of 2013, 2013 was a crazy year. 2013 was the year Knoxville was filming the Bad Grandpa movie the whole time. Mm-hmm. And to me, and I think I can speak for the rest of the guys in the Jackass cast, like it was like, wait, hold on a second. It's a Jackass movie, but we're not in it. Like, it was like, there was like Knoxville went solo, like with Jackass, you know, like now we have to figure out what it's like to be the Jackson 4, you know, like it was like this, like, I just didn't understand it. And it was scary. And I was in a really dark place. And at
you
this,
were.
Oh, yeah.
Because of that.
That was really, really like upsetting to me. Like I just went into like a dark, dark place. And
this is post rehab.
Oh, yeah.
And like you've been clean for a while. And
right. And, uh-huh. Yeah. This is, I got sober in 2008. Mm-hmm. And then I'm talking about 2013.
Right.
So on top of that, I had this show that I hosted on True TV, where, you know, we would do terrible things to people while they were singing karaoke, and that was like kind of funny. But a lot of the things involved animals, and I wasn't comfortable with what was happening. So as we went into the second season, I said, hey guys, I'm not cool with the animal stuff. And so they were like, oh, okay, that's great, you're fired. Basically, I mean, I just found out that they went with another host. Mm-hmm. So in that year, 2013, I felt from my looking at it that I had been fired essentially from Jackass and from the only gig that I had going. Like I like felt like I lost everything. And like here's this, you know, like just doomsday, gloom, dark place. And I, you know, I was acting out sexually a lot on the, you know, the comedy tour and the, you know, the whole deal. And I ended up going into that, you know, that intensive sex therapy program, making sure that I was tied up doing that when the premiere for the Bad Grandpa movie happened, because it just hurt too much to even think about being at that premiere. So I was doing that, and I come out of this this sex program. They recommend a period of celibacy when you start out in recovery with the sex stuff, because it's supposed to kind of reprogram your brain somehow. So I decided I'm gonna go for a whole year.
What do they recommend?
I still don't even remember why I kept going after a full year, but I went 461 days. And they don't recommend anything like it's very case by case.
Okay.
You know, there's not one, you know, thing that they recommend for everybody. But for me, it was recommended that I be celibate, I think, for a year.
Wow.
I went for a year and 3 months, which at the end of the day, I think was like just sort of sexual anorexia. You know, I don't know that there's anything healthy about that approach in hindsight. And I came out of that, and then I got into this relationship with someone who lived in England, that was just not gonna work. And then I got out of that relationship and I got in another relationship that was not gonna work. And then I was at a point thinking, like, I just went off the rails again, you know, like sexually. And it really, I think it's kind of like where, if you've been sober, like from drugs and alcohol, and then you relapse, mm-hmm. you kind of can't enjoy it, or like it just gets really bad really fast. And I think in the long run, that was the most helpful thing for me because then I was like, then I was just like really ready, you know. And that was back in 2016. And then 2017, I met my girl. And now here I am with like really meaningful time under my belt in from both drugs and alcohol and any kind of inappropriate sexual behavior. And I'm just in trouble with food.
With food?
Yeah, which is like, you know, it sucks
too. Like, how so?
Like, I'm just like powerless, man. And it's crazy. Like, I act out with food. Candid, I mean, you can ask my girl, like, it's like pathetic. Like, some of the food choices that, you know, like, just like, and where, like.
Like, binge eating?
Or? Like, yeah, binge eating, like, just binge eating, like, candy, donuts, like, you know, like, it's awful. And to look at me, you wouldn't think that that's the case, but I'm, like, genetically, I somehow, you know, get away with it to a degree. But here's the pisser, is that when I went to go do the mountain climbing show in Peru, I had a physical to clear me for the job.
Right.
And the doctor called me back and said, dude, you have pre-diabetes. And to me, that is the most, like, humiliating possible concept, where I've been this, be veggie, animal rights, like, eating meat causes diabetes.
Yeah.
So for me to turn around and get diabetes would, like, make me a really embarrassed dude. And, like, he's like, you gotta, like, exercise more, and you've gotta, like, knock it off with all the bread and the sugar, because you're on track to get diabetes. And in the face of that news, I can't put down the Reese's.
You can't.
Well, like, now I'm on this, like, whole thing with, you know, my food diary and all that. So, you know, but it's not the first time. And I just, like, I really am, like, I don't know. I've really got my fingers crossed for the day when I can feel like the food behavior is, you know, under control like the other things.